Hello students, today we will be starting force and laws of motion. In force and laws of motion, we will be starting momentum. First, we will define that what is a momentum. Momentum is basically a quantity which is defined as a product of mass and velocity. Means, whenever we have any particle and it passes the motion, it means that it is changing its position with respect to time. And when the position is changing with respect to time, then that particle must have some speed or some velocity. If we take velocity, then it considers the direction also. So, in case of momentum, we consider velocity. Means, the momentum is dependent of mass and velocity. As we know that velocity is a vector quantity as it is direction dependent, hence, momentum is also a vector quantity because it depends on direction. So, now we will define momentum as, and it is commonly denoted by P, and P is equal to M into V, where M is a mass and V is the velocity. If we talk of unit, then we know that the SI unit of mass is kg and SI unit of velocity is meter per second. So the unit of momentum is kg meter per second. This is, we said that the SI unit means this is the unit which is taken in MKS system or in SI system. But in case of CGS system, the unit becomes gram centimeter per second. So this is the CGS unit of momentum. We said that momentum is basically a product of mass and velocity. Means velocity describes that the body is in motion. Hence we can also state that it is a measure of motion. Means momentum is a quantity which measures or which tells us about the motion of a body. Now, we will discuss about one numerical, that how we can calculate the momentum of any particle. See, in this question, we are given the mass and velocity, and directly by multiplying them, we can get the momentum. So, mass represented by M is 100 gram, while velocity represented by V is 15 meter per second. Now, in case of mass, is we see that it is in gram, means mass is in CGS unit. But in case of velocity, it is in meter per second, that is SI system. So the system of both the units differ. Now we want the product. Hence they should be in a one system. Either they should be in the CGS or they should be in SI system. So we can convert mass. We know 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. And to change gram to kg, we have to divide 100 over 1000. That will be 0.1 kg. Now, if we take the mass and velocity, they both are in the SI system. So, momentum is 0.1 into 15 kg meter per second. That will be equal to 1.5 kg meter per second. So, this is the momentum of a ball. So, this is how we can calculate the momentum of any particle. Now we will discuss about the another topic, that is Newton's second law of motion, which describes or which states the relationship between the momentum and the force. See, the statement of the Newton's second law of motion states that the rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the applied unbalanced force. The word unbalanced force is used because if we talk of force, then the force may be balanced or unbalanced. If it is a balanced force, then the effects which are created by the force or the effects which are visualized in the presence of force cannot be visualized or cannot be seen. But if the force is unbalanced, it implies that the force which is applied will be representing some effects due to its presence. So whenever the object is moving, then its velocity might be changing, and the change in velocity corresponds to change in momentum. The change in momentum which is taking place in any body will be occurring with respect to time. So whenever the change in momentum is with respect to time, that is rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the force which is applied on any object, and that force is unbalanced because the effects which are caused by applying the force can be visualized on an object easily. Now we will discuss the statement. This is the statement. Now we will describe or we will discuss about its mathematical expression. See, let us consider that a body is there which is moving. We said that there is a change in the momentum. Now the change in momentum corresponds to change in velocity, or we can vice versa, that the change in velocity corresponds to change in momentum. So initially let us consider that mass of a body is in. Mass of a body is m and it is moving with some initial velocity v. And having some final velocity, that is v. And the change in velocity occurs in time.
Now, if we want to calculate the initial momentum, of the body. Let that initial momentum is represented by pi. So we said that the mass of body is m and its initial velocity is u. So the product of these two give us the initial momentum. Now, next is the final momentum. Now, pf represents the final momentum, which is a product of mass m and its final velocity is v. So the product is mv, that is final momentum. Now we said that the rate of change of momentum. Rate means any change which is occurring with respect to time. And to evaluate or to calculate the change of momentum, final momentum minus initial momentum with respect to time. that is divided by t. On taking the m common, we will be getting v minus u over t. We know very well that change in velocity with respect to time, that is v minus u over t, is a, that is acceleration. So we can substitute this equation, that is equation number 1, in equation above, that is m into v minus u by t, that will be giving us m into a. Now we know that m into a, that is f mass of product of mass and acceleration. So we said that we have taken rate of change of momentum that corresponds to the force. Hence we can say that the magnitude of the force acting on body is equal to the product of mass and the acceleration produced. Now we know that acceleration is a vector quantity, hence force is also a vector quantity, and the direction of force is always the same as that of acceleration. Now we will discuss about one numerical. Now, in this numerical, we are directly given that there is a ball having a mass m that is equal to 6 kg, and on applying some force, we get the acceleration of 4 meter per second square. And we want that how much force is applied. We know that F is equal to m into a. We are given both the quantities. So we can multiply 6 into 4, that is 24. Hence, the 24 Newton of force is applied on a ball of mass 6 kg to produce an acceleration of 4 meter per second square. Now, let us discuss another question. 1000 kg vehicle is moving with a speed of 20 meter per second, is brought to rest in a distance of 50 meter by applying brakes. Calculate the force. Here we are given a heavy vehicle having a mass 100 kg. Initially it was moving with a velocity of 20 meter per second, and with this speed it covered 50 meter of distance. After covering the 50 meter of distance, by applying brakes, the vehicle was made to be at rest, means the vehicle was stopped. Now we want the force which was applied through brakes to make the vehicle stop. So in this question we are given mass, that is m, that is equal to 1000 kg. We are given the initial velocity, that is u, that is 20 meter per second, and we are given the final velocity, that is v, that is 0 meter per second, as the question says that the vehicle is made to rest, means its initial velocity becomes 0, and the distance covered by the vehicle, that is s, is equal to 50 meter. Now we want to calculate the force. To calculate the force, we know that the formula is F equal to m into a. We are given m, but we are not given the a, that is acceleration is not given to us. Now we can use the third equation of motion, that is v square minus u square equal to 2as. By using this equation, we can calculate the value of a, because
we are given V, we are given U, and we are given S. So, on substituting the values, we will be getting minus 400, because U square means 20 into 20, equal to 2 into A, let it be that, and S is 50. So, on making the calculation, we get minus 40 over 2 into 50, that will be equal to minus 4 meter per second, that is equal to A. Hence, the acceleration is minus 4 meter per second square. Now we want F. F is equal to M into A. We know M is 1000 and A is minus 4. So, on multiplying we get minus 4000 Newton. So, minus 4000 Newton is a force which is applied on a vehicle to stop. Now, the minus sign signifies that there is a deceleration, means initial velocity of vehicle is more in comparison to its final velocity. And it simply signifies in the question, and it is also given in the question, that the ultimate or the at last the vehicle is made to stop, means it is not allowed, or means the force which is applied on the vehicle is made to decrease the velocity of vehicle. Okay, students, so that's all for today. Thank you.